If you just created your YouTube channel or you're a small YouTube channel, you're most likely frustrated with the YouTube algorithm. You're wondering why no one is watching your videos or how the YouTube algorithm even works. In this video, I'm going to be sharing the strategies that I personally use to rank my videos on the first page of YouTube search next to channels with millions of subscribers and millions more views than I have in order to grow my channel in my sleep. For more art and entrepreneurship type videos, make sure to like the video, jingle all my bells and buttons for new videos every Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays. My name is Janet, I'm an ex-Disney artist turned independent creator, and I've been able to rank many of my videos on the front page of search, even though I have much fewer subscribers than many of the other channels. These strategies are how I've been able to grow my channel in 2020 very quickly. That it's at now. Let's get started. My first tip is to do keyword research. Keyword research is basically how I figure out what topics are trending, what topics are lucrative for me, and how to title my videos properly. I wouldn't be able to do this without a few apps. I use TubeBuddy and Keywords Everywhere. Using these two apps, I go to YouTube search and I type in certain video ideas that I have floating around. For example, if I wanted to do some research on a YouTube's tips video, I will type in maybe how to grow on YouTube. Keywords Everywhere will tell me how often per month these words are searched in the YouTube search. TubeBuddy will tell me how competitive these keywords are. This is particularly important for smaller channels like mine and I'm sure yours. I personally like to target keywords that are not too competitive, meaning anywhere between the 2,000 to 1,000 search per month range. I personally don't like using the keywords that are under the 1,000 search per month range because in my opinion, to me, it just means that topic might be a little bit too niche. And even if I rank for those search terms, it won't be giving me much return for how much effort I put into these videos. While I don't really go above the 2,000 search results range, I would if my channel were bigger, but for my channel and for other channels that are small, it's very, very hard for you to rank for much more competitive search results. My second tip is I use these keyword research results and it informs how I title my videos. Now, I don't just pick one and just use that for my videos. I pick at least two. YouTube allows for 100 characters for the title. I will have the main title at the front of my videos, and oftentimes I will have a secondary title, just in case I can rank for one or the other, or hopefully both. The third step to making sure you rank in search is now that you have the proper keywords to use and the title, it's time for SEO optimization. I know this word is really scary for a lot of people who don't know anything about SEO, but it just means you need to put your keyword everywhere. You need to put it in the title, you need to put it everywhere in the description, you need to put it in the tags, you need to put it in your thumbnail. And this is what is called metadata. The more metadata that the YouTube algorithm has for your YouTube video, the more it kind of knows who to push your videos out to. Plus, if you take the time to do this, you will be one step ahead of your competitors who aren't doing this. This means you will most likely rank above them in search. You will be surprised how many big YouTubers don't even do this step. That is why there are so many small YouTube channels that are able to rank next to them in search. Before I move on to the next step, comment down below what topics you would like me to expound upon. My fourth tip is to increase your watch time. Remember, here on YouTube, watch time is king. If you head over to your analytics, YouTube will give you your average watch time for your videos. Most of the time, when you're a small channel, your videos will look a little bit like a hockey stick. What you want is a gradual decline, and you should be aiming anywhere between 30 to 50% watch time. If people are clicking out of your videos in the first 30 seconds, or you're falling short of that 30% watch time, you need to fix the content of your videos because YouTube's algorithm likes when you have high watch time, pretty much about the 30% range. Once your audience is able to watch up to 30% or more of your videos, the YouTube algorithm realizes that people are really engaged with your content and will start pushing it out and recommending it to people. And ranking it in search. It has less to do with how many views you're actually getting and how engaged people are with your content. That is why when people buy subscribers, buy likes, or any other way of cheating your way to getting subscribers and views doesn't really work. The fifth step to ranking in search is to pay attention to your initial views. When you upload your videos, you need to be getting a good amount of views in the first few hours to the first day of your upload. If a bunch of people click on your video in the first few hours of your upload, it's almost guaranteed to rank or go viral. Now, how many views do you need? Well, it basically depends on how competitive your niche is. So for me, I found that around 100 to 200 views in the first day is really great for me. Less than that, those videos tend not to rank in search. The more competitive the topic is, the more views you're most likely going to need in the first few hours of when your video goes live. So the bar to getting ranked in search is lower than you think. You don't necessarily have to get 1,000, 100,000 views per video in order to be successful on YouTube. The most important part is to get ranked in search, because then your video does not necessarily have to perform like crazy right when it goes live, but it will continue to perform over and over again until it is dethroned in the search. That is why YouTube is a game of consistency. The more videos you have out there ranking in search, constantly giving you views for years on end, the more these videos will stack on top of each other. And that is how successful YouTubers grow very quickly from a small channel to hundreds of thousands of subscribers. If you would like to learn more about how to use social media to grow your online business, check out my free guide, 8 Steps to Launch Your Online Business, link down below. Check out honeynapson.com for my merch. I am currently wearing the hustle shirt today. Check out these other videos to learn more about how to use YouTube, Instagram, and more for your online business. If you like this video, like the video, jingle all my bells and buttons for more art and entrepreneurship type videos, and don't forget to dare to dream.